Okay, guys, here is Wings of War, World War II rule book. I'll just go through the basics of this game. Thumper 7458 put out the World War I one. This is what you use as one plane. And just to go over it, there's a plane on the base. It's a miniature. It's actually started as a card game, so you just use this card here instead, but now they actually have miniatures. Then they have these maneuver decks, and these are all how the plane flies across the board, and I'll do a demonstration of how that works in a minute. So this plane is the Supermarine Spitfire MK1. Obviously it's from the Allied side. Then when we come to this plane, it's the Axis side, or you'll notice that it's a German plane. Same thing as the base, the actual miniature. This flight control board, I think they call it, or I call it the cockpit. You just put the maneuver deck there. What you'll notice on the miniature itself, it has a letter there, B, and that corresponds with the maneuver deck. So the planes that have B fly with that maneuver card. This red thing here is the actual device that you use to see if you can shoot somebody, and I'll go over that in a few seconds. The other things that are in front are the speed indicators. And what these speed indicators are is if you have the blue one down, it means you're going fast, and if you have the white one down, it means you're going slow, and the two other ones are just to try and trick your opponent. So here's an example of a maneuver card that if you had the white speed down, you would follow the white arrow on the card, or if you had the blue marker down, you would follow on the blue. So let's go over a few things on the plane itself before we set up a little mock display. On the card itself, you'll see on the right the letter A. That's the maneuver deck that you use, so you'll see A on the deck. The green number, that's how many hits this plane can take before it's taken off the game. If you look here, these are the markers for shooting. See the paint on my finger from Warhammer. If you're within this whole length of measuring here, you only get one shot. And in this case, then your opponent would pick from the B pile. So here is four of the damage tokens. So there's A, B, C, and D. So if you get a shot on the plane and you are within the one distance, then your opponent would have to pick a B token, not show the person that just shot at them, and then look at the corresponding result. I'll do another video about what these all mean later, or hopefully somebody else can post that with more experience in the game. So that's how that works. If you got one shot, your opponent would have to pull one B damage token. If you're within close range, they would have to pick two. When you come over to this plane, they fly using the B maneuver deck. This plane has 17 damage points as well. Except here you see the difference on the shooting. When this plane shoots at far range, the opponent picks one C token, but when you're close range, the opponent would have to pull three tokens, so one from the A and two from the C. So that's how that works. And you can see on the actual bases of the model the same information as the card. So now I'll get into doing a mock setup of how the game works. So this would be the basic setup of the game, guys. One plane flies from this side, or however many you have in the game, and the other planes come in this way. So really, that's how it should be. So, at the start of the game, each person picks a speed, and they display that. So for this case, for this plane here, I'm going to put him as fast speed, and all the other three tokens are turned upside down, so that the opponent doesn't know what speed will be the next speed. So the same as here, except this plane I'll set as going slow. And this is only at the start of the game. Now, this rule that I'm talking about here is actually under the optional rules, which is under acceleration of the optional rules. I like this better than the basic rules, so that's why I'm doing it that way. So once you set the speed, there's only a few things on the start of the game. If you look on the cards here, there's arrows to the right and to the left, and there's a few cards that you're not allowed to start the game with. One is with a star on it, and the other is the arrow that's pointing down, which is that one. And that's it. Later on we'll discuss what those are, but for now just understand that you can't start the game with any of those maneuvers. So in this case, I'll use this card, which I don't show my opponent. I put it down, and then I can actually change speeds, or if I put a blank chip down, keep going the same speed. So once that person does that, the next person, all these maneuvers happen at the same time. We'll just pick a, obviously I got my cards mixed up for the video here. We'll just pick this card for instance. It doesn't have a star and it doesn't have a backward arrow. So we will put a neutral there, so it means it's going to go the same speed. And then each person picks the next card. And same thing. If they want to change speeds now, they can put a blue one down. If they want to keep going slow, they put neutral. So we'll just play it out like this. And just as an example, I'll use this card here. And we'll go slow. So what happens is, at the start of the turn here, each side reveals what their speed marker does. So if it's neutral, that just means it's going the same speed. Here, this one's neutral, so they're going the same speed. So then they reveal their cards. So, for this plane, what you do is you line up the blue to on the actual plastic figure, you'll see a line at the front, just like what's on the card, and an arrow on the back. So what you do is you just line up this card to according to the speed, so we'll be using that line there. So you just place it in front, hold the card, line up the arrow, and that's where that plane moved, and then the card goes back in the deck. This one here is going white speed, so we have to line that up. And that's how that plane moves. So after the moves happened, you slide over this maneuver here. And then we have to resolve shooting to see if somebody can shoot.